I've got miracles on miracles, a million little miracles. Miracles on miracles, count your miracles. 1, 2, 3, 4, I can't even count them all. Miracles on miracles, a million little miracles. Miracles on miracles, count your miracles. 1, 2, 3, 4, I can't even count them all.
Hey friends, welcome to church today. I'm Tracy.
And I'm Linda. We're from Condo.
Yeah, we welcome you today in this amazing service that we have planned for you guys.
And I'm just going to share a verse that's on my heart to share, especially after Easter when we all had time with our families and, you know, we're all feeling a bit loved up. And
yeah.
So this is a good verse to share.
Yeah.
Love endures with patience and serenity. Love is kind and thoughtful,
yeah,
and is not jealous or envious. Love does not brag and is not proud or arrogant. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not provoked or overly sensitive and easily angered. It does not take into account a wrong or endured.
Yeah.
It does not rejoice at injustice, but rejoices with the truth.
Yeah.
When right and truth prevail, love bears all things, regardless of what comes, believes all things, looking for the best in each one, hopes all things, remaining steadfast during difficult times, and endures all things without weakening. I just love that verse because it talks about the things that love is,
yeah,
and it gives you the positives to look at because there's so many positives.
Oh, that's it.
Yeah, I mean,
and this whole weekend, like Easter weekend, is the ultimate sacrifice, the ultimate love.
That's right.
You know, God is love, and he came to this earth as love and to share his love for us.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, God sent his only son so that we could have life and love through him. So,
yeah,
that verse I think is a good little verse just to have a little bit of a reminder on just after Easter as we all start moving back into the regular runs of work and school and everything else.
Yes, it's been really good weekend. I hope that you guys have been spending it really with family, and the holidays are almost come to an end. We've got one more day, which is Anzac Day, and we just are very thankful and honoured for that as well, just not forgetting what the Anzacs has done for us.
Yeah, and that's right.
Yeah.
So, yeah, we just hope you can enjoy the rest of the service, the word that's being shared tonight by Pastor Sharon, and the worship song as well. So get up and shake yourself around and, you know, have a bit of fun with the music. It's always fun.
Yes.
So,
yeah, well, praise breaks open the way, guys.
Yeah.
And that's what we love. We love to build an atmosphere of praise because that allows God to move on our behalf. And
And don't forget to inbox us if you'd like some extra information or a Bible or just to chat to somebody. We're all happy to, like, get involved with anything that might be on your heart or just want to ask a question.
Yeah, and, you know, coming back to term two, we're in hub motion again. So we have hubs for all ages, guys. So check that out if you are interested in joining a hub, because we'd love for you to come along to one of our hubs, both here in Cadoblin and in Wagga as well. Drop us a line, guys. Yeah. Just
There's a hub for everyone.
There is a hub for everyone.
Yeah.
I love it. Yeah. So thanks for watching, guys. I hope that this is encouraging to you. So thanks, guys.
Yeah, be blessed this week, guys.
Yeah. Thanks. Bye.
Bye.
Jesus, you make the darkness tremble. Jesus. Welcome to our online service. It's going to be an awesome night as we lean into the Word of God, we lean into His heart, and we get some wisdom for Term 2. It's the beginning of Term 2, and I'm really looking forward to everything God is about to do. I know that He is. It's in His heart to just break some ground, to shift us forward into something new, and to just release such a grace over us that we grow and lay a hold more and more of who He is. So before I jump into the Word, I'm just going to pray. So Father, thank You for Your incredible Word and Your heart to speak into our world, to speak into this next season, to just speak into where we are at, and God, to lay something in our hearts to help us shift forward. And that's what we want to do. We want to grow in You, God. We want to see Your purpose advance in each of us personally, but also as a church community. We want to grow, God. We want to see our communities blessed because of what You're doing in our lives. So we just pray, Father, right now, that Your Word will just sit in our hearts strongly, and God will catch everything that's on Your heart. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, so I want to talk today about Jesus. And the Bible describes Jesus in a whole range of different ways. And one of the ways I love Jesus being described is the Alpha and the Omega. And Alpha and Omega are two letters from the Greek alphabet. We're all very familiar with some of the Greek alphabet these days because of COVID. But the Bible says that Jesus is the Alpha, which is the first letter of the Greek alphabet, and the Omega, which is the last letter of the Greek alphabet. So ultimately, the Bible is saying that Jesus is the first and the last. He is the beginning and the end. You know, He is present in the span of everything that is going to happen in time and everything that has happened in the past. And He is the same, the Bible says, yesterday, today, and forever. And I love that. Wrapped up in God's name, wrapped up in His identity, is the idea that God is bigger, that He is the same faithful, true, and strong God season after season. Isn't that an incredible thought? So circumstances might change, God is the same. We may change, God is the same. Challenges may come, but God is the same. The Bible says that Jesus is the author and finisher of our faith. So everything God starts in us, He promises to finish as we stay connected in Him. And there's this incredible verse in Philippians 1:6 that says, God is faithful to bring to completion the good work that He has started in us before the day of Jesus Christ. What an awesome thought. You know, we can often feel responsible to make sure we do it all in our own strength. But the reality is, it's God that starts it. And the Bible is very clear that everything God purposes for us, He brings to completion. Our job is to stay in relationship with Him. So everything about us and everything about God in us is about taking us forward, is about bringing growth, is about increasing our ability to walk in purpose, and is about God bringing us into greater measures of, I guess, largeness of heart. So if we're going to talk about moving forward, because that's what I really believe God wants to do in Term 2, is just move something forward in our lives, what does that mean? What does it look like to move forward? And I want to say this, I think it looks different on the inside than it is on the outside. And often it can look like things are progressing on a, you know, external level, but nothing's changing in our heart. And I guess my question would be, are things moving forward? If our heart isn't engaged, are we moving forward? And I think if God's going to bring growth and if God is going to shift something in our lives, it's going to be because He's done something in our hearts. Everything God does starts and ends with our hearts. And there's an awesome verse that says, out of the heart flow the issues of life. And that's an incredible verse, because that word issues just if you translate it back to the Bible language, it's actually talking about the boundary lines of our life. So our heart is actually going to determine the limits of our life or the boundary lines of our life. So how incredible is it that God is wanting to step into our world and bring increase in growth, but actually stretch us from the inside out? Because if he can do that, the limits of our life move back, the boundary lines of our life move forward. And there's this awesome guy in the Bible called Jabez, and he used to pray that God would enlarge his territory. And I think if God's going to enlarge our territory and, I guess, grow us or give us capacity to do more, he's actually going to start here. That's where growth happens. So there are seasons where the track God has us on can often double back on itself because everything's about the heart. And I can actually look sometimes like I'm got it all together on the outside, like I'm moving forward, like God's building something in me, like I'm making progress. But as I said before, if something hasn't shifted here, then there's got to come a point where things start to double back so God can actually deal with the issues of my heart. And I remember a few years ago just going through a really tough time and, you know, just coming back into my my work life and my church life without really having processed properly what had happened. And shortly after that, maybe about 8 or 9 months after that, I just fell to pieces. And, you know, in the process of just trying to work out what happened and why I got to where I got, I realized that I hadn't actually let God into my heart. At that point where I needed him most, I focused on trying to make sure the outside of my life looked all together. And I remember at that point, God just taking me back to some of the things that I hadn't yet dealt with and just giving me grace and bringing some healing and bringing some wisdom and just resetting my life. And, you know, was that growth? Yeah, it was. On the outside, it actually wasn't looking very much like I was moving forward at all. But on the inside, God was working incredible shifts and incredible changes. And so it takes incredible courage to let God take us on the journey of the heart. And that is ultimately where growth starts. And so if we're going to step into term two and we believe God's going to do something new, just know he wants to speak to your heart. He wants to shift things in our hearts. Sometimes he'll want to revisit some stuff from our past or to revisit some things that he wants to go deeper in our hearts. And if that's where you are, don't feel that you've gone backwards. You haven't. God is actually moving you forward. But in order to do so, he's actually doing a journey in your heart. So open your heart, let him do that work in you, and ultimately recognize that the foundation of that is actually a foundation of trust. And there's this awesome verse in Proverbs 3, verses 5 to 6. It says, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he will make your paths straight." And I love that verse. You know, we don't have to understand it all, but if we trust God, the promise in his word is that he will make our paths straight. Even though it may not be logical, it may not make a whole lot of sense, if the foundation of what's happening is trust, you can absolutely guarantee that God is going to go before you, he's going to make straight the path, he's going to clear the way, and he's actually going to cause you to move forward in a way that you could never have taken yourself. That's an incredible promise from the word of God. In Psalm 119, there's this verse that says, the word of the Lord is the lamp unto my feet. And I love that verse because, you know, there's been points in my life where I felt reluctant to step out because I haven't been able to see the end from the beginning. And, you know, I like to plan things, and there's been holidays where I've known where I'm going to stay at different points. And, you know, there's been also some holidays I've gone where it's like I've jumped in the car and had an amazing time going, will I turn left or will I turn right? And I think sometimes we've got to take our hands off the driving wheel and let God actually lead us. So that verse about God's word being a lamp to our feet is ultimately a reminder that we don't need to know or see the whole journey to actually walk the walk with God. We just need to see the light of God shining where we are right now, to find his heart where we are right now, and trust him that he is going to take us from that point onwards. So we may not see where the path is leading. We may only be able to see where we are right now, but God's word is a lamp to us. It shows us, number one, there is a path. Number two, it shows us where the path is. And number three, it'll show us where there's maybe obstacles that may trip us up in our journey. And so I'm going to finish tonight by praying just for God's light to really light up where you are right now, for His wisdom, His grace, His goodness to just show the way, and for God's incredible strength to be with us all as we step into Term 2, 2022. So Father, thank you for every person that is listening today. I thank you that your heart is for us to know you and walk in relationship with you. And the foundation of any relationship with you is one of trust. God, where we give you control, where we let you lead the way. God, where we allow you to take us where we cannot take ourselves. And so right now I just pray for every single person listening, for myself. God, that you will help each one of us trust you, to surrender to you, to give you full control, and to follow you. I thank you that as we do that, God, you are going to open a way. You're going to do a deep work in our hearts. You're going to strengthen and equip us for the season ahead. And God, I thank you. You want to bring us into a largeness of heart, a largeness of faith, a largeness of experience with you. And we just honor you. We exalt you, Lord. We thank you for who you are, Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the one who starts and finishes this incredible work of faith in us. Lord, we just thank you for that. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, God bless you guys. I pray that's an encouragement to you. And as we do step into 2022, into Term 2, 2022, feels like the beginning of a new year, I really encourage you just to come along to our, you know, gatherings, our face-to-face gatherings. I know for me personally, when it comes to growth, a lot of it happens in my relationship with God, but there's a huge amount that happens as I just walk in friendship and community with other people. We're not meant to do this journey alone. So I encourage you, if you're in Wagga, to come along to our face-to-face services, which are 11 a.m. on a Sunday morning, or come to one of our hubs. And if you are in condo, it's 5:30 p.m. on Sunday night. We've got some amazing hubs starting up this term. It's going to be an incredible term. We really would love you to be a part of it. Have a great week, and we'll see you next time. Bye.